Hi everyone, welcome you all. In our previous video, we have seen some of the testing blocks in Jasmine, like describe block, it block, before each, after each, and before all, and after all. Now, in this video, we are going to see a few more blocks in Jasmine, and they are F describe block, X describe block, FIT block, XIT block. So basically, F describe and X describe. Suppose one spec file can have multiple describe blocks. So each describe block is representing a suite. Suppose let us say I have a spec file. Inside the spec file, I have a multiple describe blocks. So I want to execute on specific describe blocks. Let us say I have 10 describe blocks created in one spec file. Then I want to execute specific describe blocks. Then I can specify the describe block as if F describe block. And similarly, suppose I have a 10 describe blocks, I want to disable some describe blocks. That means I don't want to execute those describe blocks in the runtime. Then I can make them as a X describe block. So let me show you one example how we can use F describe and X describe block. So let's go to Visual Studio Code. And here I'm creating a new JavaScript file under test cases. Let us take a new file. And here I'll name it as, let's say, Jasmine. testblocks2.js. So this is a spec file in JavaScript. And in this, I'm going to create multiple describe blocks. One spec file can have multiple describe blocks. So let's just create a few describe blocks. I'll say describe. And here I'll say two arguments we need to pass. The first argument is the name of the suit. So for that, I'll just name it as first describe. First describe and comma. The second argument will be the function, and this function we need to implement. Inside that describe, I can just write one it block also. Let us say it, and this is my first it block. I can say here, I'll say first it block. You can write any number of it blocks inside one describe. For now, I'm just writing only one it block. So it block, and here also we need to write a function in which we need to implement the test. So inside that function, I need to write something. Let's say for now, I'm just writing a simple message. Let's say console.log. And here I'll say, so this is first it block from, or it block in the first describe block. First describe block. So this is basically the first it block in first describe block. So this is one it block I have created inside the one describe block. So describe is representing the suit, it is representing the test. Now similarly, I will also create a few more describe blocks. Let's say one and two. So two, three describe blocks total I created. So the spelling is mistake. So let me just describe. So describe block. Right, so now I have created three describe blocks. Now let me just change. This is my second describe block, and this is my third describe block. This is the first it block in the first describe block, and here I'll say this is a second it block, and this is my third it block. So now first describe block contains the first it block, second describe block contains the second it block, and third describe block contains the third it block. Now I can also change this message. I'll say this is my second it block in second describe block. And this is third it block inside the third describe block. Right, so now I have created three describe blocks in one spec file. Now let us run this for now. So let's go to new terminal. And by using protractor command, you can run it. So I'll say protractor. And before running this, we need to update the spec file name inside the conf.js. Let's go to conf.js, and here we need to specify the spec file name. So our spec file name is Jasmine test blocks 2. Right, so now save it and then execute the file. So protractor inside the conf folder, my conf.js file I'm executing. Now enter. Now currently I have a three describe file, a describe blocks in my test. It is launching my browser. Close it, and now we can see there are three specs I've executed from three different blocks. And you can see here, we got three messages from three it blocks. If I just go to my spec file, first it block, second it block, and third it block. So what does that mean is we have successfully executed all three it blocks from three different describe blocks. So by default, we are able to run all the describe blocks. So here my requirement is I want to execute a specific describe block. In runtime, I want to execute only specific describe block, not all the describe blocks. So in then what I can do is we need to just specify if describe. So for example, I want to execute only third describe block, then make it as F describe. So F is nothing but a focused describe. So now this only the third describe block will execute now. So rest of two will be ignored. Now let us see and save and again run the test again in the terminal. I'll say protractor, just a second. Yeah, protractor conf.js. So when I say F describe, only that particular block will be executed and rest of two blocks will be ignored. Right, so now we can see the output here. We got only one of three specs. So totally three specs are there, one, two, and three specs. But we executed only one spec. And what is the output we can see here? This is output we can see here. This is third it block in third describe block, right? And suppose I want to execute two describe blocks, second and third. Then we can also make the second one as F describe. Now save it. Now let us run one more time. Now this time two describe blocks will execute. Launching and closing my browser. So we can see here ran two of three specs. So currently two F describe blocks are available. So those two blocks are executed and the first describe block is ignored. So this is how we can use the first block, which is F describe block. So this is means focused describe block. We can ignore the rest of the describe blocks. And similarly, we also have X describe block, which will disable the describe block. So for example, instead of F describe, I'll mention that X describe. Then what happens? So when I say X describe, apart from this describe, rest of the describe blocks will execute. So this describe block will be ignored at the runtime and rest of the describe blocks will be executed. Now we'll see how it is going to execute. So here I make second describe as X describe. So let us run the test again. The second test, second block, I'll make it as X describe. So execute once again. Now it is launching my browser and then closing my browser. Done. So now you can see here, there is one ran one of three specs. There is only save it and only one spec has run among the three. So you can see here what are the messages we got. This is a third it block in third describe block. So here you can see first, second, and third. So third we haven't changed, right? So still it is F describe. So it is only executed. Rest of them are not executed. So I can also make this as a describe. Now we can see the output one more time. So here I have made only one block as X describe. So this describe block will be ignored. Rest of two describe blocks will be executed. So X describe block will be ignored. Now let us execute one more time. Clear. All right. So now we can see here there are two specs of three. Two ran two of three specs. That means only two specs have executed among three. And this is the first it block and third it block is executed, but the second block is not executed. So what is the second block here? X describe we mentioned. So except this particular block, rest of the two blocks have been executed successfully. So what we understood here is when I say F describe block, this block will execute at the runtime and rest of the blocks will be ignored. And when I say X describe block, at the runtime, the X describe block will be ignored or disabled and rest of the blocks will be executed. And same thing we have for it block also, F it block and X if it block. And when I say F it block, the it block will be executed at the runtime. And when I say X it block, this block will be ignored or disabled at the runtime. So we'll see one more example for exit and F it. So let me just close it. And let's go back and create one more example under test cases. Create a new file. I will name it as Jasmine test blocks 3.js. So now this time we will see fit block and exit block. So here fit block in the sense the it block will execute. So this is focused and this will only the block will execute and rest of them are ignored. When I say exit block, so this block will ignore, rest of the blocks will execute. So now let us see the example. So here I'm creating one describe block and I'll say describe, and here I'll say some name to the describe. I'll say describe block, some name I have given. So I'll say describe block and should be implemented in the function. I'll create one function and inside this I'll write multiple it blocks. So the first it block I'm writing, and here I'll give some name is, I'll say first it block. And here the test should implement in the function. So we need to implement the function. So here I'm writing simple message console.log, console.log, and this is first it block. This is my first it block. And similarly, I will also write multiple it blocks inside the same describe block. Three it blocks I have written. So this is my second it block, and this is my third it block, and you can also change here. This is a first instead of first, I'll say second, and this is my third it block, and this is my second it block. Sorry, this is my first it block. This is my first it block, and this is my second one, and this is my third it block. So one describe can have multiple it blocks. So currently I have only one describe which contains a multiple it blocks. So by default, if you run this spec file, all three specs will be executed. All three it blocks will be executed. Let us try to execute. So just go to convertx, convert.js, and here change the name of the spec file, jasmine-test-blocks3.js, and save it and then execute it. So currently I have a three it blocks in my describe block. So by default, it will execute all three specs. So all three specs have executed. We got output from all three specs. So now what I'm going to do is I want to execute a specific it block or focused it block. So then we can just make it as FIT. So now this only the first it block will execute, FIT block will execute, rest of them are ignored. Now save it and execute one more time. So now it has started execution. So this time it will execute only FIT block, focused it block. So we got a message only from that particular block. You can see here. So only one spec is executed. The output of that it block is, this is first it block. So FIT block is executed and rest of them are ignored. And similarly, exit. Suppose when I say exit, so the same block will be ignored and rest of them are ignored. This is exactly opposite of FIT. So this time exit will ignore and rest of the two it blocks will execute. Now let us execute and see. So execute this command. All right, so now we can see totally we have a three specs and one pending spec. So what does that mean is exit block is ignored. This is a pending. And rest of two have executed. So we can clearly see here. So that this is a second it block is executed, second it block executed, third it block is also executed. And when you come to the third, temporarily disabled with XIT. So that means whichever the block we specified with XIT, that is temporarily disabled and which is a pending. So rest of the specs will be executed. So this is how we can use F describe, X describe, F it block and X it block. So F describe will focus to describe block. If I have a multiple describe blocks, if you want to execute specific describe block, you can specify that block as a F describe block. Or if you want to ignore any describe block, then you can specify that block as a X describe block. Similarly, if I have a multiple it blocks in the describe, so if you want to execute only specific it blocks, we can specify that block as a F it block. And similarly, if I want to ignore any it block or if I want to disable any it block in the describe, we can make it as a X it block. So these are the different blocks are available in Jasmine framework. So in the next video, we will see a few more blocks. So that's all for this video, guys. Thanks for watching.